Next, invite Bhupati from Enerpark Energy.
Good evening, everyone. I represent a company called Enerpark. We are a German MNC. You can see one of the installation in Delhi International Airport, Terminal 3. Whoever goes later in the evening, dispatches from Delhi, you can see our power plant there. So it is beautifully installed and maintained plant. Just a brief introduction about our company. We started in 2008. It's our headquarters in Hamburg, Germany. We installed 2,000 megawatts in 18 different countries. We have three regional offices. One is in Hamburg, Germany, another is in California, USA, and Bangalore in India. And in India, we represent two more offices in Delhi as well as in Bangalore. So we have 1,000 megawatts of IPP. It's our own assets. We installed in across Europe, USA, and India. And right now we are doing around 1,300 megawatts of asset management. So the term is asset management is the concept of asset manager is a bit different from what Indian asset management company thinks about it. So our asset management really feels about four real terms. One is managing about the real assets in the sense physical assets, what is it? And second thing is about the assets of operation maintenance of the assets which we own. And third one is the commercial. And commercial points, what we statutory compliances, environmental compliances, all these three parts will take care. And the fourth one, we can of course say financial model, getting the IRR, getting the money back to the customer, client, bankers, whatever it is. So these are the four key elements. We call it as asset management. So the asset management for us, it's completely different from the O&M, and it's completely different from the asset management point of it. So we are the one of the company which is in the IPP protocol, and we are into the 10th position. We heads of Adani or some companies whoever have holds in up in Indian assets, and we are number two in Europe. Consecutively last 2 years we installed more power plants in Europe, and still we are doing it pretty well. And we are doing projects in Africa, starting from even we are doing projects in Asia Pacific, all these regions, and we are pretty well doing in USA. So let's move to the current trends and about the event. Of course, we all into the end of the session. It means that our event also become like our O&M budget, less visitors, less resource. So let's see what are the challenges we are facing in Indian solar asset management. First is about the manpower. Of course, Indian manpower costs around 70 to 80% of total O&M budget. Into it, there is another term called technical skill and compliances issue. So in India, there is a compliance issue is called minimum wages. It's got introduced in every state. So now if you go to the minimum wages point of it, the labor salary is much more higher than the engineer salary. So that act we have to compliance it off. And of course, there is a EF and PF, ESI, all extraordinary strategic compliances, because we are really facing this issue because we do a lot of projects which related to airports and government organizations. We have a projects in India like Ashi Port, airport, all central government organizations. So we do face these issues. And the second and the third point is water and other natural resources. Of course, water is an issue. Many states it has fishing issue. And of course, we need to find some other alternative for the water resources. And the final important point is the EPC quality. So as the PPA rates are getting reduced, the as prospective of that, the EPC prices also getting reduced, the quality of Indian solar assets rapidly coming down. So that is maybe that is one of the issue we are facing in it. And second major issue we are facing is the grid. So there is a grid code. So we have a grid code like other inverter manufacturers very specialized in manufacturing 60 hertz inverter rather than 50 hertz inverters. And protections, of course, like other person who has into such protection issues. So the grid system which you are connecting in Indian assets are maintained very poorly. So that protection system we need to kept into our websites, and the unscheduled maintenance, we can call it as curtailment issues, which we used to face a lot of revenue losses in it. And forecasting, there is another point we have to look into. We need to submit a lot of forecasting issues. And third major point is the commercial issues, complexity of various models. Yes, We do operate in various models like rooftop, capex model, opex model, open access, PPA, and you know, CSR projects, even school-based projects, MNRI register projects. So Indian asset, solar asset is simply very much, it's not simple, very much complexity in it. So as asset manager, we have to look into various models and we have to finance into various protocols and ILIT. And of course, the major issue for as far as this commercial point is billing and collection. And everyone sitting over here very well know about that. How does it difficult to get generate the bill and collect the bill? Even full stop mistakes, comma mistakes makes you payment delays. And financial modeling, as said before, that is the point. And the vendor management also, which related to the complexity of various projects. Let's see. Now the trends in the solar asset management. Since morning, the legends, the veterans spoke about a lot of various trends which is going in the solar asset manager. From me, I've been into Europe, I've been into US and been into some of Asian Pacific countries. So these are the small things which we observed in various countries. They were following it. So I just want to bit and pieces of, I want to just touch in it. So model cleaning, one of the recent trends which the Europe countries as well as Indian countries which uses robotics. Of course, Ecopia is one of the very familiar country in entire India and Iran based and US and everywhere they are doing it. And the sprinkler method, which is they were more famous in USA. It is mainly into the rooftop power plants. Due to that, due to the structure in the rooftop scale, we could not use the robotic method. People use sprinkler method. It's like water sprinkler with some water, soft water solution in it. So it cleans the module everyday basis, but it requires a lot of water. And third one is module cleaning equipments, which means that in a tractor you can attach a brush. You can, if you have a pitch, very good pitch in the modules, the tractor run in between the rows and cleans up. Sunbrush is the another company who does pretty well in our German plants. So these are the recent trends which is in the model cleaning segment. Coming to the IoTs, it is nothing but Internet of Things. So the monitoring, of course, our partner Lucas over here. So they are very much doing it with us in US plants. So they have a satellite data which helps us to what is the real-time radiation. I can compare my pyranometer data and solar sensor data with this satellite data, so I can assume whether my models are cleaned or and my pyranometers are cleaned. So I need not to look only for PR, I can look for the theoretical data. Of course, everyone, solar asset people are facing 30% of reduced energy production in this year, particularly from the PV cyst, because there is a drastical changes in the climate. So this satellite data will helps you in more about getting the what is the real-time PR recorded, irradiation recorded over there. And forecasting, many of the utility power plants now record a forecasting strategies. Of course, there are various companies doing that. And controlling, of course, sitting in the head office, and once you have fleet management like centralized monitoring system, if you have power curtailment perspectives, you can control this one thing. That is only possible through Internet of Things. And another point is trading. Trading we are normally doing in German plants that may come in Indian also. Indian power exchange can do that. So it may also come into the picture later in this point of it. And coming to the last, asset management. So asset management is, as said before, we need to watch our physical asset, how it does performs. So this web-based cameras has, in the sense, it's a URL link. If you click this link, you can able to, this web-based installed in four corners of our plant. It can able to zoom up to the module level. And you can watch the vegetation growth, module cleanness, security purpose, and each and everything we can watch. We can inbuild this system into the monitoring system. So sitting in the head office, you can monitor entire plant performance. So that is one of the system. Another one is ERP. ERP, which means there is a company called Power Factor, which is based out of USA. So in this company, you can get the online work permits, tax, warranty tracking, and navigation. So if you want to go to a particular site, if you have the tab and you can navigate and you can reach the site without any other's help. And the weed management, particularly into the, if you want to avoid the grass cutting, we should implement such weeds. Such weeds help you out to not like Bermuda grasses, which will helps you to stop the growth. That's particular equivalent we have to find in India. That's all for as of ENAPAC. So this is what the simple and pretty things we are doing in India. So we are managing 27 plants in India. So I like to thank our partners EQ especially and GMR This is our one of key client, Lucas, Maitra, Jinsol, everybody as well. Thanks for the opportunity. Good luck. Bye-bye.
Thanks a lot, Bhupati. There were a lot of interesting things mentioned, not only from a ground mount perspective, but also from a rooftop perspective, which has been fairly missing in this conference today. With this, I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Karthik Narayan Sharma. I head growth and strategy at Sunshore Energy. We are a 3-year-old company and we've put up close to 35 megawatts, which is diversified across rooftops and ground mounted. We primarily deal with commercial and industrial players, and we look at EPC as well as asset management. In terms of asset management, again, we as a company have a very tech-driven approach. I myself am from a pure play analytics background and have created multiple solutions for Fortune 500 companies across the world in my career. And so a few things that I personally feel are, or that one singular thing which I think has dominated the discussion today all day, is data, right? Which I've been to multiple EQ conferences before where we've had developers and EPCs and all kinds of players, but data is not something which features at this, you know, in this magnitude in those conferences. But today, I think even from developers as well as, you know, pure play O&M companies like SolarPro and EPC companies, international EPC companies like Enerpark, we are realizing that, you know, the amount of data that is that solar is generating is definitely, you know, a force to be reckoned with. Having said that, there have been multiple very interesting technologies that we've seen today. One thing that, you know, that is very close to my heart in terms of, you know, when it comes to data in solar, is that there are multiple technologies to capture data, but none of them really, you know, bring in ease of capturing data. Especially there is this, so drawing again from, you know, earlier sessions, we know that there are three primary costs in asset, in operations and management, be it a rooftop plant or be it a ground mounted plant. Number one is your cleaning, right? Number two is your technical staffing. You need engineers either centrally located or on the site. And number three is security, especially when it comes to ground mounted plants, right? These three together make up close to 60% to 65% of the cost. Now, when it comes to cleaning, it definitely needs optimization, right? But we still don't have, you know, a lot of ways of collecting cleaning data. For example, in a 50 megawatt plant, do we really, you know, look at things like route optimization when it comes to, you know, our people going and cleaning plants? Especially because I think 95% of the cleaning in India or more than that happens manually, right? So that definitely needs optimization and is a big problem to be worked on. You know, we need to collect which tables are being cleaned when, if not on a real-time basis, but definitely on a daily basis. Number two is technical staffing. So the primary reason or the primary work that technical staff does at a ground-mounted site is doing preventive maintenance tests, right? But is there really a good solution in the market to capture this data in a structured manner? I don't think so. We capture all this performance data, and you know, all that we've been talking about today is that, you know, multiple and multiple GBs and TBs of performance data is coming in, but by itself, performance data will not let you do any of the machine learning or, you know, control and all of that that we talk about. Because essentially when an inverter shuts down, it's not producing any data, right? So there has to be, you know, some solutions which collect and also help us marry performance and preventive maintenance testing data, right? There's a big gap in the market there. And number three is security. So security needs assistance. Right, having 3, 4, 5 people at a 50 megawatt plant does not really guarantee, you know, line of sight across the plant, right? So there, video analytics, you know, and all the solar plants have cameras, am I right? And especially IP cameras nowadays, right? But is any company really applying video analytics to use on their plants? Probably not. At least no one's come to us trying to sell a solution like that. In fact, one very funny thing that happened is that one of our smaller plants in Haryana, one day we just realized that, you know, the inverters tripped. But again, you know, that typical approach of, you know, doing a root cause analysis, we couldn't figure out why the hell the inverter had tripped in the morning, right? We lost some 15 minutes of generation because of that. Later on, we went on and we processed the video of the inverter room, and we found out that the security guy had come smoking a BD, and he just ripped off the inverter and went back, you know, just like that. And this is something we have the camera there, but is it any use? Not really. I mean, well, you've already lost generation, you go back and check. So these three things is, you know, where I think is a definite urge from the industry in terms of technology building. And I'd like to conclude with that. So from each of our sessions, I'd just like to ask quick questions from all Gagan, Nitesh and Bhupati. First of all, from Gagan, Gagan showed us something very, very interesting today, which is, you know, use of augmented reality in dealing with plant issues. So everyone's seen Snapchat and Instagram filters, right? So that's augmented reality, really, right?
Unfortunately, I'm not on Snapchat.
Okay.
So, but augmented reality, I mean, the fact that it is visual look and feel, we assimilate so much more. So if anything, we had to refer back to some attachment somewhere or some folder and then go hunt for a document, versus everything being visually in front of whatever it is that you're doing, I think that makes a humongous difference. The only challenge is that we need to do this pre-EPC stage, because once we get it at O&M stage, we frankly don't have the budgets. I hope that answers.
So next question is Nitesh. Nitesh, being from a company like Godrej, which is, you know, whatever they've produced or gone into have kind of dominated it on a national scale, right? Solar is, and all aspects of solar, right? Be it developing assets, be it engineering assets, or be it, you know, operating and maintaining assets, is something which in India, to me at least, it seems like a very localized thing, right? All three things. There are dominant EPC players by region, there are dominant developers by region, and there are dominant O&M players by region. How do you see you know, Godrej kind of what kind of approach do you see, and what kind of future do you see? Do you see a national future or a local future for your company?
As I told you, that Godrej is about 115 years old company, and we are moving slow, but we are moving very cautiously. Number one point, we add about 100 installation every year, be it starting from 10 kilowatt to 1000 kilowatt. Now if you talk about, we are going on a national scale, we have about 70,000 dealer and a channel partner base from our different divisions who are working with us from past 20 years or 25 years, be it an interior furniture. So we are utilizing their network to penetrate in the market, number one. And second, if you talk about the localized O&M partner, or what I personally think, we generally give 5 years defect liability period as per Ministry of New Renewable Energy guideline, that any fault will occur, will EPC has to replace, rectify or repair. So first of all, we take care of that in design parameter. Rest is more of an cleaning thing. So I recently went to an ashram which is based in Sonipat by the name of Sanjeevani Ashram. That plant has been installed by Tata. This is 500 kilowatt solar power plant which is installed on the ground. So though there are two devotees who cleans the plant every day. 6 o'clock, 5 o'clock, they wake up, they do chanting, yoga and everything. 6 to 7, they clean the plant every day. So this kind of a commitment attitude should be there if you talk about O&M partners. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Nitesh. So, so any questions from the audience?
We have any questions from the audience? Okay.
Please take the mic. Yeah, hi, this is Gurdeep Singh from WebDin. We are specifically into remote monitoring solutions, and it's a French company. My question is specifically to Mr. Vikas. Mr. Kartikin, sorry. In your concluding remark, that's better now. In your concluding remark, you were mentioning about your particular site that, you know, where you saw that the production got down because the inverter was shut down by a local security guy who was just smoking a cigarette or a video over there. And you realize later when you go through all your video, which eventually, put you in some sort of loss. My idea is that what you have thought of, you know, are you still relying on to those cameras or videos, or you have still thought of to put up something which will alert you immediately if something that sort of happens?
As far as alerting is concerned, that, you know, you can get alerted about whether something is on or off, right? Alerting is binary, right? You got to take action on this is all that alerting says. What I was talking about is a root cause analysis, right? Which is usually an on-site thing, right? Which is more of a qualitative affair, right? Not so much quantitative. So definitely we've got, you know, systems in place which alert us, and we've got, you know, whatever, you know, cutting edge technology when it comes to monitoring all our plants, whatever is available in India. But yes, in things like these, you know, video camera is something which, if I can start generating alerts using my videos, right, it's things which are happening around you, is a very different kind of alerting, which, you know, a monitoring system which is monitoring, let's say, telemetric data which is coming from my machines will never be able to give me, although it is absolutely important. Does that answer your question?
This is what my point was, like, you know, when your inverter is tripping, if you are actually monitoring some of your dry contacts straight away, you know, whether somebody, if somebody has eventually, you know, intentionally or unintentionally has turned it off, you immediately, you know, can get the alert why it has gone down instead of realizing after 20 minutes.
If I can add to that, I don't think in our process we look at malicious intent by a security personnel. Yes, we do get an alert from our SCADA. Yeah, so.
Yeah.
Sure, since the morning I'm listening a lot about modules and your fellows cleaning and how get a warranty. Anybody has not discussed about Libit, how to make this guy who looks like Libit dumb, how to make it smart, which is coming out in rooftop. This technology is coming up very fast. And what they are using, this power optimizers and other thing, and the data which we get it from here. And by the way, I am from a system integrator, a small system integrator station in Bangalore. Then we are using for the maintenance, as what is creating a miracle. We can get so much information. But I noticed since morning, we never touched that subject. Maybe we are talking about utility, not that much in rooftop. Anybody has that comment on that? I'm not talking about only this panel in general.
Yes, there are solar optimizer which has been recently inaugurated by a solar company called Solar Edge. At present, this company is growing very fast, number one. Second is, that company is new. We are also proposing one solar optimizer that helps you to monitor performance of every module, which we generally do for say 500 kilowatt run. We cannot individually monitor that particular module. That helps in getting the rectifications. Second is, but that inverter cost approximately double the price of the present inverter, number one. So client has to be ready to pay that solar optimizer cost. So we the EPC contractor are ready to use that solar new technology, but the industry should support the system. At present, I was discussing with some of the colleagues, there are about 2,800 EPC players which are prevailing the market. You know, as the competition increases, consumer get benefit. If you talk about old days, we need to, we are struggling for margin, to be very frank. All of us are struggling for margin, running the expense. But if this is not because of the, I would say, policy or industry, but this is because of the competition. In our old days, we need to pay for the receiving a phone call as well. We need to pay for that. At present, the SIM cards are available free of cost. because of the competition. So the customer has to give, the someone has to educate people about this technology. We are ready to adopt that.
Sorry to allow me another. On these comments, we did a little bit of work on this string versus, and I slightly with respect disagree with you. It's coming very close to that cost, slightly higher than string inverter, and that advantages. And we have done around, of course, this solar edge is not new. It was done all American IT companies like Cisco. They have done a megawatts of the car park installation with solar edge. But yes, now it's getting popular. We have done around 450 kilowatts, and we convince the customer on the price level, an advantage like that. It's coming out very less different. So I think it's a more work to be done. I'm not a promoter of the solar edge, by the way. We are a system integrator, but we are using this for the O&M.
So I think you highlighted a very important point that today's discussion missed out IoT in some sense. We did not get a chance to speak about what all devices are out there and what all readings we can take. So I think that is something that got missed out.
Actually, my question is related to the fact that...
So kindly introduce yourself and your company.
I'm Richard from Aspiration Energy. We basically are an INC specialist. So the question is actually, what's happened is in India, you have such a large variety of EPC players and such varying quality. So I just want to ask the panelists, do you all see an opportunity? Because what's actually been happening now is that there are a lot of assets which are created which are going to become NPAs. This is definitely going to hit this industry sooner. I think it already started. And I think the next opportunity will come, especially for people who are here, is going to be how to revive those assets which have become junk or near junk. And that is not because of poor panel quality, but it's basically because of some pathetic practices that have been happening in this industry. And that's all to do with one god that everybody seems to worship, that is L1. So L1 means that you just get the contract and you somehow, by God's grace, you try to do something and put up the plant. And of course, the INC and the maintenance part is the least thought of. And so I just want the comments of the panelists.
Jay, I think you bring out a very important point with regards to L1. But with regards to junk assets, I think we should meet afterwards. We'll find a solution. We'll buy something. Yeah. So definitely L1 is not the way to go. It's a life of 25 or 30 years, and that's what we need to look at.
And it's very true that some plant has not been installed as per quality. There are diverse kind of a client which are available in the market who only looks for quality, who looks for price. There are different EPC contractor who just fool their customers. So India is a diverse country, population more than 125 crores. So you will find each and everything. So there is principle called opposites values are complemented to each other. So a bad EPC contractor or bad plant will increase the value of a good plant. A bad EPC contractor will increase the value of a good plant. So you will find different customer and different plants in India. Right?
Okay. So indeed, has been an interesting day, and the closing session definitely added to the entire value created by the presence of everyone. And I request everyone to for a big round of applause, and big round of applause for the audience. They have been extremely patient and good, and we were also like really encouraged and motivated by doing this conference. Good quality people in good numbers attended the conference, so thank you very much for your precious time. I'd like to request Mr. Karthikeyan to present small mementos to the fellow panelists, please.
Thanks a lot, Anand. This was a great show, and I think this is the first asset management conference to be held in Delhi.
Yeah.
And definitely a very interesting one and a very important one, as it has turned out.
Thank you, thank you. And I hope India keeps on building more and more assets every year. And the confusion around various confusions subside, and the dust settles fast, so that we get to meet and do more of such
conferences. Can we get a round of applause for EQ as well for organizing this event?
Thank you for spending. Thank you for.